Hello, Dr. Sushma Singh this side. Today in chapter 6, International Organizations or United Nations and its organizations, lecture starts with the topic India and the UN reforms. India has supported the restructuring of the UN on several grounds. It believes that a strengthened and revitalized UN is desirable in the changing world. India also supports an enhanced role for the UN in promoting development and cooperation among states. India believes that development should be central to the UN's agenda as it is a vital precondition for the maintenance of international peace and security. One of the India's most concerns has been composition of the Security Council, which has remained largely static while the UN General Assembly membership has expanded considerably. India considers that this has harmed the representative character of the Security Council. It also argues that an expanded council with more representation will enjoy greater support in the world community. We should keep in mind that the membership of the UN Security Council was expanded from 11 to 15 in 1965, but there was no change in the number of permanent members. Since then, the size of council has remained stationary. The fact remains that the overwhelming majority of the UN General Assembly members now are developing countries. Therefore, India argues that they should also have a role in shaping the decisions in the Security Council, which affect them. India supports an increase in the number of both permanent and non-permanent members. Its representatives have argued that the activities of the Security Council have greatly expanded in the past few years. The success of the Security Council's actions depends upon the political support of the international community. Any plan for the restructuring of the Security Council should, therefore, be broad-based. For example, the Security Council should have more developing countries in it. Not surprisingly, India itself also wishes to be a permanent member in a restructured UN. India is the second most populous country in the world, comprising almost one-fifth of the world's population. Moreover, India is also the world's largest democracy. India has participated in virtually all of the initiatives of the UN. Its role in UN's peacekeeping force efforts is a long and substantial one. The country's economic emergence on the world stage is another factor that perhaps justifies India's claim to be a permanent seat in the Security Council. India has also made regular financial contributions to the UN and never faltered on its payments. India is aware that the permanent membership of the Security Council also has symbolic importance. It signifies a country's growing importance in the world affairs. This greater status is an advantage to the country in the conduct of its foreign policy. The reputation for being powerful makes you more influential. Despite India's wish to be a permanent veto-wielding member of the UN, some countries question its inclusion. Neighboring Pakistan, with which India has troubled relations is not the only country that is reluctant to see India become a permanent veto member of the Security Council. Some countries, for instance, are concerned about the India's nuclear weapon capabilities. Others think that its difficulties with Pakistan will make India ineffective as a permanent member. Yet others feel that if India is included, then other emerging powers will have to be accommodated, such as Brazil, Germany, Japan, perhaps even the South Africa, whom they oppose. There are those who feel that the Africa and South America must be represented in any expansion of the permanent membership, since those are the only continents not to have representation in the present structure. Given these concerns, it may not be very easy for India or anyone else to become a permanent member of the UN in the near future. Now let us discuss next point, the UN in a unipolar world. Among the concerns about the reform and restructuring of the UN, it has been the hope of some countries that changes could help the UN cope better with a unipolar world in which the US was the most powerful country without any serious rival. Can the UN serve as a balance against US dominance? Can it help maintain a dialogue between the rest of the world and the US and prevent America from doing whatever it wants? US power cannot be easily checked. First of all, with the disappearance of the Soviet Union, the US stands as the only superpower. Its military and the economic power allow it to ignore the UN or any other international organization. Secondly, within the UN, the influence of the US is considerable as the single largest contributor to the UN. The US has unmatched financial power. The fact that the UN is physically located within the US territory gives Washington additional source of influence. The US also has many nationals in the UN bureaucracy. In addition, with its veto power, the US can stop any moves that it finds annoying or demanding to its interests or the interest of its friends and allies. The power of US and its veto within the organization also ensure that Washington has a considerable degree of say in the choice of the Secretary General of the UN. The US can and does use this power to split the rest of the world and to reduce opposition to its policies. The UN is not therefore a great balance to US. Nevertheless, in a unipolar world in which the US is dominant, the UN can and has served to bring the US and the rest of the world into a discussions over various issues. US leaders, in spite of their frequent criticism of UN, do see the organization as serving a purpose in bringing together over 190 nations in dealing with the conflict and social and economic development. As for the rest of the world, the UN provides an arena to which it is possible to modify US attitudes and policies. While the rest of the world is rarely united against Washington, and while it is virtually impossible to balance US power, the UN does provide a space within which arguments against specific US attitudes and policies are heard, and compromises and concessions can be shaped. The UN is an imperfect body, but without it, the world would be worse off. Given the growing connections and links between the societies and issues, what we often call interdependence, it is hard to imagine how more than 7 billion people would live together without an organization such as the UN. Technology promises to increase planetary interdependence, and therefore the importance of UN will only increase. People and governments will have to find ways of supporting and using the UN and other international organizations in ways that are consistent with their own interests and the interests of the international community more broadly. Here we come to the end of the lecture. Meet you on next lecture. Thanks for the listening.